talking to
Yes.
Thank you. right in the middle of the ring. He knows where it goes.
It's in the middle of the bleachers.
He knows where it goes.
Tell me you just picture it like a place for it. And you'll know what to do.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank you. about ready?
Thank you.
gonna bring our two minis in first. Okay. It is Caleb Viger and Trevor Emery.
Friends, family, parents can get pictures. So come on in here and get a picture if you want one.
a big moment. Come on in, get the picture. Good morning, how are you? You figured out the trick finally to get your cat's attention, did you? That's pretty smart. That was creative. It's good to be creative. So I'm going to ask you a question here. I'm going to have you introduce yourself, so your name and your parents' name, and introduce your helper too, okay? And then tell us the name. Okay, so you tell us who you are and your parents are, and then you introduce your helper, okay?
My name is Caleb Weigert. My parents' names is Tammy and Steve Weigert. And my helper today is Emily Weigert.
Good. And what is your cast name that's with you today?
Thunder.
Okay. Did you get to help name your cast, or did somebody pick it for you?
I got to help name my cat because the next day there was a storm.
Good. I'm interested to hear why their cats are named what they are. Okay, so the next thing is, do you like ice cream? Okay, what is your favorite flavor of ice cream? You can pick any flavor. They had every single one.
Vanilla.
Vanilla. Classic guy, huh? It's a classic. Vanilla. Okay, great job. Congratulations. They're going to have something special for you at the end. You heard what we just did down there, right? Okay, so can you introduce yourself and your parents and your helper today, please?
My name is Trevor, and my mom and dad are Rachel and Kyle.
Thank you.
Good morning, and thank you for having me here today with you at the Fulton County Fair. So we're going to start the day with a spring calf that we have in the class. She's a single entry, but it's too bad because she could withstand a lot more competition. She's so long from her hooks to her pins, has a lot of sweep of rib and blends smoothly throughout. Thank you, young man, for starting our show out well. Congratulations. Thank you.
Give these kids a round of applause. Interface that with me to start these three calves out today. The calf that I chose to start the class today, I said, isn't the biggest calf in the class, but in my mind, she's the best calf in the class. She has that femininity and refinement of a bone to her, which I was showing the kids, particularly, you know, when you look at the front leg, you can see that refined dairy bone. She's also more chiseled at the withers, and she's more nearly level from hips to pins, and I appreciate the sweep of rib that this very correct heifer coming out in first has today over the big, strong calf that we have in second. It was a closer placing in second over third for me today, but I think there's just too much size and scale in the black heifer for this very correct, refined heifer in third to get around today, not only in size and scale, but also in capacity and width overall. But a very well-made heifer, just not quite the growth and width of the second place heifer today. Congratulations.
Winner calf, first place was Aubrey Long, second Terry Grossman, and third Jesse Rockwell. Next is summer yearling of Emily Viber.
Thank you.
take a lunch break for our summer yearling class, but I told this young lady I particularly appreciate this heifer in her front end. She has that strong, powerful front end that's full in the crop, and she blends so smoothly from head to neck and neck to shoulder and throughout. I told her if I were to change this heifer a little bit, she does have a little bit, perhaps too much set to her hock, but it's not a thorough placement issue. But again, beautiful, lovely front-ended heifer for our summer yearling. Congratulations.
First place spring yearling, Emily Viger. Oh, sorry, that was summer. Now Emily's bringing in her spring yearling. So I asked at the table if this spring yearling was out of the same cow family as the summer yearling, because I do think that they look very similar. Again, the beautiful front end, smooth blending on this heifer, a lot of depth of heart girth and sweep and depth to that rear rib. This heifer is more nearly level from hips to pins, a little easy in the hock perhaps, but overall a very open, smooth blending, stylish heifer to win our class in the spring yearling today. Congratulations. First place spring yearling was Emily Viger. We're now going to show for junior champion. Okay, spring calf is Jesse. minor calf was Aubrey, and second place was Terry. First summer yearling was Emily, and first spring yearling was Emily.
pulled the three heifers along the rail here that I feel are most in contention for junior and champion today. I think when you look at these heifers, you can see the kind of calves I look are like. They need to be balanced. I need that feminine, refined bone to them. I like calves with some width and some spring of rib and some style to go with it. So we have the two calves in the front, the March calf and the winter calf, who are, I believe, very similar in their makeup. They both have a lot of femininity and refinement to their bone. They both have that sweep and openness of rib, and they blend so smoothly throughout. And the same goes for the spring yearling down here on the end. Again, another very balanced heifer. They're pretty correct on their feet and legs, and they have all the rest of the parts to go with it. When she walked in the ring, though, this spring yearling down here, you'll be our junior champion today. Congratulations. She caught my eye right away, and I knew that she would be our junior champion when I saw her come in today. She not only has all the balance and style to go with it, but she works so well with this young lady. When she walks around the ring, she picks up her feet, kind of likes to show herself off a little bit. She's just got that I'm pretty look to her, and she knows it. So if you watch her walk around the ring, again, I said she works so well with this young lady, and she's so balanced and correct throughout. So it did get a little closer for me in our reserve junior champion today, but the calf that I feel is most my kind will be this little spring calf. Congratulations, you're our reserve junior champion today. And I feel she most closely follows the pattern of my junior champion. A little more correct on her feet and legs. She's got a little more femininity. Yes, there's more sweep to the rib in this honorable mention I have here in the winter calf, but she also has that width and just so much style and malice and a leg to her. I think she's going to keep growing. Congratulations to you, though, on our honorable mention, a very nice calf. Thank you for sharing, everybody. Congratulations.
Junior champion was Emily Biger with her spring yearling. Reserve champion was Jesse Rob Wolf with the spring calf, and honorable mention was Aubrey Long with her winter calf. We'll give them a minute to do something with their calves, and then we'll do the two cows. Emily has a junior three, and Jesse has a five-year-old.
today. We have a cow that's been fresh since June 10th. So she's pretty well on her money. She's chiseled at that vertebrae. She's sharp at the withers and clean over the hooks and pins. Looks like she's been working hard for the people who are milking her. You particularly love her about that forward attachment. It's long and smooth blending and has a lot of venation. The teats are set squarely beneath her and has a nice strong suspensory ligament. She blends smoothly through that head to neck and neck to shoulder, and there's a lot of light to this individual. Congratulations, young lady, on your 3-year-old cow.
Emily Viger, first place, junior 3. Next in the ring is Jesse Rockwolf with his 5-year-old cow.
Young man has a 5-year-old cow that he's sharing with us today, and I talked to him. She has had 4 calves, however, this time didn't quite go as planned, and that's okay. Sometimes that happens. But he does have a cow that's proven herself and a cow that he can breed to. She's long from end to end. She's so nearly level from hooks to pins, and a strong, straight-lined individual, and still good on her feet and legs for a 5-year-old cow. Unfortunately, we don't get to see her fresh because it just didn't work out perfect sometimes. But congratulations and thanks for sharing your cow with us today.
First place 5-year-old cow is Jesse Rockwolf, and Emily can bring her junior 3 back in for senior championship. Thank you.
before I name our grand champion today, I want to share a little something with you that I'm not sure a lot of people know about the Dairy Project. Maybe all of you have been part of the Dairy Project, and maybe some of you haven't. If anybody, though, maybe a lot of the ladies up here will learn something about the Dairy Project. So the Dairy Project, I do believe, the only project I know of that you have a 3-year investment before you even have anything that's truly eligible for Grand Champion. I know the Swine Project, the Beef Project is a couple years. A lot of them, it's a year or two and you're done. In the dairy industry, to even be eligible for Grand Champion, you've invested 3 years of your life into that animal. You had a cow, a heifer to breed, and she's not a champion, but you want a champion. So you're planning which bull you're going to breed that heifer to try to get your champion animal. So there's all the trying to get her bred, picking the right bull, what's going to make your champion. Then you finally get a calf. If you're lucky enough to get a heifer calf, here you go on to year two. Year two, you raise the heifer. Maybe she's born the right age. You get to show her as a heifer. But she's really not eligible to be the overall grand champion. But you want to keep her growing. You want to keep her looking right. Her health is very important. Her calf health, I should say. Then you have a yearling. Step two, you have to get her bred to calve right in time for the fair. So ideally, you want that April, May, June calving to have her looking right to be eligible for that champion. Then she finally calves as a 2-year-old cow. A lot of times the 2-year-old cows don't win champion, but finally 3 years later you finally have an animal that's eligible for champion. So let's give these kids a round of applause because they've all got a minimum of a 3-year investment to become cows here to show at the fair for us today. But with that story, I'm sure that's no surprise to you that our fresh cow, our 3-year-old fresh in June, will be our grand champion. But to take nothing away from the 5-year-old cow, like I said, there's all that involved. And sometimes it just doesn't work. He had his cow bred. She lost her calf. Things like that happen. And it's disappointing after you put all those years of effort into it. And I think you need to give this young man a round of applause, too, because he's been working at this project for 10 years, and he's done a great job. But again, our fresh cow is going to be our grand champion. Love that forerunner attachment. It's long and smooth blending with all that venation about it and that nice deep cleft. Squarely placed teeth to go on this very feminine, chiseled body that she's expressing today, and she's also very square on her feet and legs. We have this big, wide, strong, powerful, long cow here that's our 5-year-old, and he's done a great job with her, but today just wasn't her day. But congratulations to both of you.
start with showmanship. Aubrey, she is our only junior this year.
Thank you.
give this young lady a round of applause. She's our junior showmanship winner today. So I talked with the young lady a little bit as she was leading her calf around, and she helped wash the calves this morning, and she said she's got a good brother that helped her get calves clipped, and they work together pretty well sometimes. So anyhow, we talked about the side to the judge goes back on the back legs, and the front feet set square, but I said I always worry about the back legs first, and if the front ones aren't perfect, well, sometimes you gotta take good enough. We looked in the ears, we talked about the head carriage, and about stepping to the side when you walk around the front. She's gonna come in and join us for the next showmanship, and I'll do a little more work with the kids there, but congratulations, she did a great job. Junior Showmanship Bell Trophy is sponsored by Gary Farmers of America. Next is our Senior Showmanship, and Terry Grossman and Aubrey can come back in too.
Our grand Champion Trophy was sponsored by Kelly Heckerman and Kathy Easterday in memory of Donna Charlotte Snap and Gary. And our Reserve Grand Champion Trophy was sponsored by the Herald Farm. Our judge has graciously donated her money back to our trophy fund also.
Just a few exhibitors today in the dairy show. I wanted to spend some time with some showmanship stuff. We're not crunched for time, so I appreciate to have the opportunity to have time to work with your kids. And your kids have been very great to work with all day, and thank you very much. Congratulations to all of you for doing a good job with these kids and they're not rolling their eyes at me and wanting it to be over with, and I appreciate that. So anyhow, that means you're smiling. So today I talked to the kids a little bit. Again, we talked about the side to the judge goes back. He runs those front legs square, stepping off to the side when I go in front so I can see the width between the chest floor, and then anticipating that I'm coming around to the other side and getting those feet switched. I told the kids again, leave yourself room, stay off of the gate so there's room for the judge to walk between, which they did a good job with that. And then I told them that I'd always set up on the corner of the ring to watch those animals walk away from me. What I'm watching for when the animal's walking away from me is I want to see if she treks straight with those hind legs. So I told the kids that when I get back there, she's going to look a lot better if she's not walking in a zigzag pattern. To go ahead and try to walk that animal straight out from me, I said, look at the judge, look at your calf, look at the judge. I'm sure some of you parents have told them, like, judge, calf, or calf, judge, whatever. You have to pay attention to both. I'm going to walk out nice and straight. And the kids did that. We talked about pulling in nice and straight and pulling in close enough to the animal ahead of you that if you're at a bigger show with more animals, there's not room for a cheater to squeeze up in there and take your spot. So anyhow, with that, there was an individual that was able to walk his calf out a little straighter and anticipated switching those feet when I walked around the front to the other side. And he'll be our showman in this class today. Congratulations to you. You both did a great job with the head carriage. I did see him push the back down and try to make them nice and straight across the top line, and they're doing some of those extra things. So congratulations to both of you. Your kids did a great job.
Showmanship winner. Next is our master, Emily Biger and Jesse Rockwolf.
told the kids before the show so they had time to prepare a little bit. I didn't want to surprise them. But I told them that I wanted to come up and share a little bit with you on the microphone since they're older and they've been in this project a while. So as dairy farmers, we're not always so good at sharing our story because we're always afraid of backlash or what people might say, and will we say the right thing. But youth are, I found, pretty fearless, and they're really great at sharing their story. They go on social media, and they really have the loudest voice right now. We appreciate them sharing their story in the industry. So anyhow, as we come up here to the end of the show for the senior showmanship, I told these kids that I wanted them to kind of share their story about how they got here, how is it possible that they're able to show this project, who are the people who are influential and key to have them here, and it also gives them the opportunity to thank the people that have made this possible for them. So I wanted them each to have the opportunity. It will not count towards their placing. I'm not taking it in consideration for the placing today. I just wanted them to have that opportunity to share the people that have, or thank the people and share that have made it possible today for them. So.
Alright, so my name is Emily Viger. My parents are Steve and Tammy Viger, and I have a little brother named Caleb. So my grandma and grandpa have always had dairy cattle in their lives. They've always been milking. And I just kind of wanted to help carry on their legacy with the cattle that they had. And so I got my own and brought them home. And so my first cow that I had, she's 5 years old now. Had 4 or 5 kid calves, and she's just really my big baby, and I don't know, and I wouldn't be here where I am without having her and my grandparents leading that up towards that. Both my parents have been a big part of my life too. They both helped me be more confident in myself and helped me grow as a person. They've helped me get my calves where they're supposed to be. They're the ones that help me milk these cows in the morning and help me milk them at night. They're the ones that help me get to school every day. And so that I'm as proud to be the person that I am and as lucky as I am to have them as my parents and the cattle that I have.
I'm Jesse Rock Wolf. My parents are Kelly Wolf and Jesse Wolf. And I wouldn't be here today if it weren't for the two people standing behind me. They've really done it all for me. They've been there every moment. And they've done everything for me, and they did it for the first 4 years, and they said, now you've got to do it. So I took over. I did a lot of it this year, and they were always there to support me. And since I was young, since I was a baby, they've always been part of it, and I've always loved doing it. And my 7-year-old, she's not here today, but she's what really got me started. She's my, just like Emily says, my little baby. I wouldn't be here if it weren't for her. You could let her go and she'll walk herself around the show ring, and it's just amazing. Thanks to Harold Farms, all the Rock family for everything they do, and especially Grandpa Wallace for as much as kid that it's taken throughout the years. And all the supporters that I've had throughout the years, and there's too many to name, and I thank all of you that have supported me.
Walked their cattle out straight. I want them pulled in nice and straight I did the feet check, switching feet. Cow goes forward on a cow on the judge side. You switch feet when I walk around. His front feet are square. They stand off to the side. Something I noticed with the senior showman that I wanted to point out, because I did notice it with the juniors, but at that point sometimes it's hard to switch things up a little bit because you need to do what your calf is used to. But I do appreciate seeing them put their hands in the halter on the dairy animals. I know that the steers, you leave the hand outside of the halter and pull from the chain. But those females, I like to see that halter in and not dragging on the ground. You have it moved up. The kids are very attentive. Also, I noticed, or you may have noticed, that instead of just standing on the corner when I got behind the kids, I kind of stepped in between the two to make sure that the animal behind me was going to wait their turn and not run me over. Sometimes I'm in shows and there's more animals and I'm trying to watch one walk and then I get a big punch in the back from the heifer behind me. And these kids were aware of their spacing. Nobody ran over me. But there was one individual who did pull in straighter, left me more room, was a little quicker and stronger with getting those feet moved on the animal. And that's going to be our young man. He'll be our, master, senior showmanship winner today. To take nothing away from this young lady, she's very smooth on the halter, young lady, and you did a great job. There were some times I caught you a little close to the gate, but you're very smooth with your animal. Your head carriage is beautiful. Maybe the cow was a little bit of a tug-of-war game for you, I realized. Something else I was looking for that I would like you kids to do, though, that I should have mentioned before I said who won. But when I switch halters, what I wanted you to do was make a circle around the animal, because when you're showing someone else's animal, you need to kind of find those faults and the strengths to the animal so that you can show them to the best of the ability. So if you're doing showmanship at State Fair or an open show, make sure you make that circle so you're aware of the strengths and weaknesses of the animal before you take the halter, all right? Okay, congratulations to all of you. Great job. One more award to give away today to a 10-year member, a Dairy Career Award. But as you heard or saw in the showmanship, this young man's been pretty special. This whole entire family's been pretty special and crucial to the dairy project here in Fulton County. And the people that these kids thank, the entire Rock family should be getting an award for running the show, pulling it together, and lifting these kids up and showing them how important they are and promoting our industry well. So since he was a little boy, before he could even show in 4-H, I do believe, I've seen this little dark-haired boy working his butt off at the state fair. And we're down by the wash rag, so every day I'd see him dragging an animal, usually had a pusher, sometimes no pusher, back and forth and back and forth. He was the first 4-H'er, I do believe, and he spent a lot of time in the wash rack. I bet when he came back, I bet his fingers and toes were wrinkly, because it'd take him all day, back and forth, and back and forth he'd go. I cooked breakfast, he was going back and forth. I cooked lunch for everybody to stay fair. Here, Jesse, back and forth, back and forth. So, he's always been a worker ever since he was a little kid. I've always seen him working and trying to make things the best he can, and he's having fun too, but he's always been a worker. And then I got a little story, a little information about him. As he got older, he didn't mind working, but he decided that maybe he should put it to good use, to where it kind of works out pretty well for him, that he started charging people to dump their wheelbarrows at the fair. And were you surprised how many lazy people there were that were willing to pay quarter or a dollar or whatever to dump their wheelbarrow. So he's innovative as well. He's a hard worker. He's innovative. This whole family has been a stand, like a monument almost, their skulls, at the State Fair since I can remember, since I was a youth. I remember their home at the State Fair. I remember the girls as little kids, as 4-H'ers at the State Fair. And to see Jesse come through and the rest of these kids come through, it's been really special, and I'm really blessed to have been a part of giving such a great young man this award. And congratulations to you and the whole family. And I've seen how you help these kids, and you are truly making a difference in the lives of not just those little kids. I see them look up to you. I see them watching you. I see them wanting your help, which I see you helping them not only in the dairy, but I've seen you through high school even. I've had the opportunity to see him grow as a young man. And congratulations to you. You've all raised quite a great young man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You know what the best part is?